Hey everyone, Coach Lance from OnlineHockeyTraining.com, and welcome to another installment of the Sunday Motivational Video. Each week, I'll try to broaden your horizon by providing you with some new information that hopefully will make you a little wiser and improves your hockey life. Today we're going to be talking about the between the legs shot. It ain't no trick shot no more, ladies and gentlemen. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe and don't forget to turn on your notifications or you'll be missing out. Not too long ago, we retweeted the sensational goal by Columbus's Sonny Milano. Did you see it?
Nah, I was watching a little baseball that night. What happened?
Well, something pretty special happened with the Columbus Blue Jackets when they faced off against the Dallas Stars on October 16th. Some are calling Mr. Milano's tally a goal of the year candidate. Let's take a look.
A couple times, which as a shooter, he just got to unleash it.
Left wing.
Across the line. Next move by Milano. Walking right in. Scores! What a goal! It's 3-1 Columbus. Well, everyone down here on the bench, everybody in the building is smiling because what just happened? Sonny Milano, who took a penalty earlier in the game, didn't see much ice time in the first, and here he's going to get sprung, and as he does, nice move on coming in, and then what happens? It's between the legs, snapshot. That's a trick shot by Sonny Milano. How you doing? As he beats Ben Bishop, far side. Bishop comes with him, but then Sonny sticks it back. Cuts it back, not only back against the grain, but between the legs. And there, look at all the smiles on the bench. Yeah, Sonny, we knew you had it in you.
Isn't that why we watch the NHL? To see players pull off spectacular goals like you just witnessed? But I have a problem with this, and we have a situation. Not with the goal itself. Head coach John Tortorella described what he witnessed best.
Well, it's just, I mean, look at it. I mean, I'm watching it right now. I mean, it's ridiculous.
Again, I don't have a problem with the goal itself. I agree, Sonny Milano's Gino is 100% a candidate for the goal of the year. My issue is with the perception of the shooting technique. And are you really surprised by the goal? Come on, it's Sonny Milano. First, before we go any further, let me ask you, did you previously ever hear of Sonny Milano prior to this big goal? I asked a bunch of players I had lessons with for a couple days who were 12 to 18 years old, and only a couple of them knew who he was prior to this jaw-dropping offensive wizardry. Okay, so what's the purpose of this video? It has a few parts. As you can imagine, I'm going to break down exactly what the Blue Jackets forward executed, but we're also going to take a deeper dive and investigate Mr. Milano's path to the NHL, which isn't what you might expect. Let me get things going by getting something out on the table right away. Listen to this announcer describing the goal.
And here he's going to get sprung, and as he does, nice move on coming in, and then what happens? It's between the legs, snapshot. That's a trick shot, that's a trick shot, that's a trick shot, that's a trick shot by Sonny Milano.
It ain't no trick shot no more. You don't think so? All right then, I guess I'm gonna have to show ya. The story of the between the legs shot came on the hockey scene back during the 2005-2006 NHL season, where there was an epic shootout between the Washington Capitals and the New York Rangers at Madison Square Garden. Unlike the Olympics, where one shooter can shoot as many times as the coach chooses, remember TJ Oshie at the Sochi Winter Games against Russia? The NHL disallows any shooter going for a second attempt until every other player on the roster has taken a turn. Most NHL shootouts rarely run out of forwards before the game is won. But back at Madison Square Garden in the mid-2000s, the Caps and Rangers went deep into their rosters where some defensemen had to have a turn. This battle wouldn't end until the most unlikely candidate skated to center ice, 6'6", 238-pound New York defenseman Malik Malik. Unfortunately, the big man wasn't known for his goal-scoring ability, but he had to give it a go. Let's listen to the call.
Malik now.
6'6", 238, not a noted goal scorer, but he's going to give it a shot here.
Malik has not scored this year. In on Kolzik. Fake between legs! Oh, Malik went between his legs! And the Rangers win it in a shootout!
I've seen it all.
Unbelievable! Are you kidding? What a shot What a shot by Malik!
This place has gone bonkers.
The Rangers mobbing!
I remember the first time that I saw it. I was like, what the heck did I just see? Since Mr. Malik introduced the hockey world to the between-the-legs shot, there's been a few more NHL players who would give it a try as well.
Like Daniel Sedin, Kris Versteeg, Tomas Hertl, Nick Falino, Nathan Gerbe, Mike Ribeiro again, Antoine Vermette, Filip Forsberg, Nick Falino again, Aleksander Barkov, Matthew Tkachuk, Steven Stamkos, Filip Forsberg again, and finally, Connor McDavid.
That was just a small sampling of NHL players who converted using this shooting technique. As you've seen, this shooting method is here to stay, and in the future should be eloquently conveyed, like this announcer demonstrated on a recent Matthew Tkachuk between-the-legs goal.
And we've seen this a number of times, not only from Matthew, but a lot of the young, talented players in the game with that move through the legs. I mean, that is such high skill. And to do it under pressure.
What you have to understand is that this shooting or passing option is available to every hockey player out there, but only a few take the time to invest in themselves and prepare for more scoring situations that others just leave sitting on the table. That's why some players bring crowds to their feet with goals like I've shown you here today, and others just celebrate with that individual. The latest player to wow us recently was Sonny Milano. So how do you go about learning this dazzling shot? It's easy. You want me to show you? Begin by straddling a line 6 to 7 feet long. Start out by pulling the puck between your feet with the forehand toe of the blade. As the puck gets closer to your feet, the bottom hand will slide down the shaft of the stick and the top hand shoots out to the side of the body. The other variation is pulling the puck in with the backhand side of the stick blade. The bottom hand still slides down and top hand shoots out to the side of the body. Once you get more comfortable with that, now try to pull the puck all the way past your feet while using both the forehand and backhand. The final phase is to add the shot. Regardless of what variation you're using, there's a quick separation from the stick and puck prior to impact. The song you'll be saying while learning this shooting technique is pull, pop, pull, pop. At the beginning of showing you this shooting technique, I said that it's pretty easy to learn. It is. I've been teaching it to players for years. What's not easy is attempting this in a game when the pressure is on, like Sonny Milano did. And look where he shot it from. All of the between-the-legs goals you've seen in this video were right on the doorstep, tight to the net. Look where Sonny released the shot, from the hash mark. Never seen one go in from that distance before. That's what makes this goal so special and rare. If you haven't heard of Mr. Milano, he busted out online during the 2014 NHL Draft, where he was selected in the first round, 16th overall, to the Columbus Blue Jackets. You might have forgot his name, but most of you have seen him before, and it was during the 2014 NHL Combine, where he dazzled the camera and people standing by with a puck trick routine that few had ever seen before. I mentioned at the beginning of this video that Sonny's path to the NHL wasn't what you might think. This Massapequa, New York native spent 2 seasons with the U.S. National Development Program, where he competed against teams from the USHL and colleges. Most U.S.-born players will go on to play at the college level before making the jump to the professional ranks. If you're a high draft pick, rarely will these players play through to their senior year. An example of this would be Minnesota native Casey Mittelstadt. He played high school hockey, some USHL before and after, was drafted in the first round by Buffalo, 8th overall during the 2017 NHL Draft, played 1 season with the Minnesota Golden Gophers.
That's where I played. Go Gophers.
He left after his first collegiate season to embark on his professional career. Players drafted in later rounds, or not drafted at all, will generally all play the full 4 years before turning pro. Instead of Sonny choosing to play Division I hockey, he went up north to Canada's Ontario Hockey League, playing 1 season for the Plymouth Whalers, where he recorded 68 points in 50 games, before signing an entry-level contract with the Columbus Blue Jackets. So how did Sonny Milano get to this point in his career and have a tally that could very well be the goal of the year? Did he just get lucky?
Yeah, he's probably one of them gifted ones anyways.
You couldn't be further from the truth. This kid has been putting in the work. I'd say probably since he started to walk. Mom and Dad Milano, am I right? As a kid, in addition to any winter season, spring AAA schedule, summer clinics, strength training sessions, he's done one thing more than most other hockey players, and that's that he's accumulated an enormous amount of extra skill acquisition hours in an off-ice environment. How do I know this? Let me show you. Before we saw this from Sonny Milano, we first saw this back when he was an 18-year-old at the 2014 NHL Combine. But when I investigated a little further, back when he was 14 or 15 years old, I believe, he entered a contest Bauer offered back in 2011, where Sonny submitted a video on how he'd change the game for a chance to win a free pair of APX skates. Okay, so let me do some quick calculations. If Sonny is 23 when he did this, and was 14 or 15 years old when he did this, that means that in order to acquire the skill he's displaying here, I would say, hold on a minute, I almost have it. 1 second. There we go. I'd say from an off-ice stick handling and shooting perspective that in order to be able to acquire the skills to demonstrate everything he's shown in the Bauer video, that he probably has been occupying this room for 7 to 9 years prior to him entering the contest, amassing hundreds of hours in this little sanctuary. I bet you, if I had a conversation with Mr. Milano's parents, they'd say he'd lived in this space as a kid. Am I right, Sonny? You can leave a quick comment below if you'd like. That'd be awesome. All right, I got lessons starting shortly, so I gotta wrap it up. In this video, we learned that the between the legs shot ain't no trick shot no mo, and should be in the same barrel as the wrist shot, the snap shot, the slap shot, and the backhander, okay? Thank you very much. We also learned that Sonny Milano's between the legs goal versus Dallas should be up for goal of the year. I'm going to go on record and say that this will be the goal of the year.
Best of luck with that, Sonny.
We also learned that one element of his game that he didn't leave on the table and took full advantage of was off-ice stick handling and shooting, where he accumulated thousands of hours handling a puck and developing his scoring touch when others chose not to. It's not an accident or luck how he scored this amazing between-the-legs goal. He's been preparing for this opportunity his whole life. If off-ice stick handling and shooting is something you're currently not doing, but after watching this video, you now have an interest, check out my online program, which houses the world's largest database of off-ice stick handling and shooting drills over at onlinehockeytraining.com. Why? Because I can help. Check out if you need an off-ice stick handling and shooting coach, because I'm your guy. Well, that's a wrap for this video. If you enjoyed it, please throw me a like and share it with someone in your hockey circle. I'd appreciate it. Remember to keep putting in the extras and dream big, bigger than everyone else. I'll see you next time.